Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to episode 51 of Live at the Whiskey Lounge. My name is Steve Rashid. For those of you who have not, I see some familiar faces, and so welcome back to any of you who are continuing to come. We really, really appreciate your support of live music here in Evanston. It means really means the world to us. And for those of you who are new, welcome, and thanks for coming. Let me take a few minutes and explain a little bit about the series, and then we'll turn it over to the reason you're really here, which is the great Bobby Broom Trio. I'm blowing my own surprise here. Okay, where was I? So about a little over a year ago, I'm also a musician. I was playing on the stage downstairs and saw this room and thought it was beautiful, and it was a brand new venue. And I asked the managers what they were planning on doing with this room, and they actually hadn't yet completely figured it out. So I pitched them the idea. I thought, what a gorgeous room. This would make a great jazz room. So I pitched the idea of doing a once-a-week jazz series here, and they liked it. And so here we are. We've been here almost every week since then. We started it on March 20th last year, so it's been actually 50 shows. This is our 51st, as I said. And last week was our one-year anniversary. So we kind of focus on... Yeah, thanks. One of the reasons I like this room is because it's so intimate, and it is kind of invites this sort of house concert in a club atmosphere, which is what I really like. So to that end, we really have designed this as a listening room, and I say that begging your indulgence here. We're really, people are here primarily to hear the music, so we certainly don't mean you can't talk to each other, but if you do chat with each other, please be respectful of the fact that people are here really to listen. As you look around up here, you see what looks like a lot of superfluous technology. Don't worry, we're not going to kill you with volume here. There are a lot of microphones and cameras here because for every show we do a live multi-track recording, much the way we do in the recording studio. I bring equipment from my own studio, and we do a live recording, and it's available to the musicians. We do it for archival purposes. The musicians are free to use that recording for whatever they choose. And we do a live stream on the web. So you can, of course, we would like you here every week. If you can't be here, tune in. You see little table cards on your tables. Please feel free to take those. It'll give you, in fact, this last week of the month is always a fun week for me because I get to put out the cards for what's coming up in the next month. So you'll see what's coming up in April. We really have a great lineup in April. Please feel free to take those cards with you. There's a website on the back. That's steverashidpresents.com. Go there. You can go there and watch the live stream. And if you want to watch a show from a previous show, they're archived up there for you to see. So feel free to take advantage of that. And I give a shout out right now to my wife, who is in Hungary as we speak, and she's watching, I am told. Hi, Bea. Hi, Mark. Hi, Michael. Hi, Monica. So that's a quick little segue into we have had, I think now over 15,000 views of these videos in 118 countries. So it's really kind of incredible. I don't know how they're finding us, but they are, and it's really quite delightful. Appeals to my inner geek to do this. I'd like to give a quick shout out to two people. One of whom is sitting over there, and he operates our video end of it. And it's Carl. Is he there? Oh, there he is. Yeah, Carl Ross, my good friend Carl Ross, who really designed the video end of this. And I want to acknowledge him primarily because, well, first of all, he does a great job every week, but he wasn't here last week when we did our big annual, our big anniversary celebration because he was getting married. So give Carl a big congratulations, and thank you a week late. What haven't I covered? I think I've covered pretty much everything. You can see, I'll come back. At the end of the first set, I will come back and we'll chat a little bit with the musicians and invite your questions. If you have any questions, again, this is a communal event. It's a live event, and we couldn't be doing this. It would be a much different thing if you weren't here, obviously. So we rely on you, and we're thankful for you. And if you have questions later, please feel free to ask them. We'll provide that opportunity for you. I can talk forever, obviously. I'm going to get out of here now and let you hear the fantastic Bobby Broom Trio. Bobby was here back in December. We were so thrilled. It was part of a WDCB event. WDCB is our co-sponsor this year. We're very grateful for them, the great jazz station here in Chicago. And they sponsored an event specifically to bring Bobby here, and we were so happy. And I was delighted that Bobby was interested in coming back, and we immediately were looking for a date to come back, and he's been on the road so much, it's been hard to find a date. So Bobby Broom, Dennis Carroll, fantastic bassist, and Makaya McCraven, who's this incredible drummer, you are in for a real treat tonight. And we'll talk to him more later, but for now, let me get out of the way and turn it over to Bobby Broom Trio. Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I could probably just talk, but I want to make it. I want to make it official. So I'll talk on the mic, even though I don't really know what to do with this microphone. I feel like I should be a bass drum right now. how you guys doing? All right. Okay. Okay. Good. I'm glad. We're getting there. You know, this is a precarious music. It's really something. And it just really is something. I love it, but it's something else. How about Dennis Carroll at the bass? Dennis Carroll, the one, the only. And Makaya McCraven at the drums. Makaya. So, I probably shouldn't say this on the stream, but whatever. Man, we haven't played together in what? How long? A while. It's been a minute. Makaya's been traveling the world, and you know, we're all quite busy doing various and sundry things. So, we finally had a chance to get back together today, and you know. So we're getting there. We're getting there. Yeah. We're getting there. No, I don't know. Yeah, exactly. That's it. It's about the journey, right?
Where so, is the question?
And where is right? We're not quite sure. No, I think we know, but that's okay. So just to give you a little update, in case you haven't already heard, we have a new CD. It's not new anymore. It's about a year old going on about a year old. But that's okay because it's our most recent, I should say. And it's called My Shining. I'm still trying to mess with this mic. It's called My Shining Hour. It's a collection of really American gemstones that have lasted throughout generations, really. Some of the songs we did were from the 20s. I'm trying to remember. Oh, Jitterbug Waltz, which was actually the impetus for the record. We were looking for something to do, and not being one to just, oh yeah, let's just play some standards and call it a day. I asked Dennis to look for some material that would, reflect the group well. Something though along those lines of jazz material, which we really haven't done a whole heck of a lot of. We do more music. We just do music and songs. We like songs and we like music, and we play jazz. And so that to us is enough. If we find some good material, then we do it. Like whether it's from Jimmy Webb. Or Mama Cass, or wherever it comes from, if it's good, Leon Russell, if it's a good song, then it's good for this music. So in any case, Dennis came up with the idea to do Jitterbug Waltz, and that spawned the concept, if you will, for the record. And I tried to look for material that was along those lines, not too overdone, but classic. And so that's the latest record, My Shining Hour. It's a collection of that. And then we have a bunch of other records that we've done over the years. We started recording in, I guess, about 2001. And although Dennis and I have been playing together for 20 years or more than 20 years, but it took us a while. We had to practice about 10 years before we started recording. Not just kidding, but anyway, okay, so we're going to continue now and do something. I'm not sure exactly what. Hopefully I'll remember it.
Let's try it.
Thank you.
Dennis Carroll at the bass. Makaya McCraven at the drums. Thank you very much. We appreciate you. And we are going to take a short break, and we'll be back. Thanks a lot.
Thanks so much, folks, for sticking around. And we will let these guys take a much-deserved break and maybe chat with them a little bit in the second set. The first of all, how about it? Bobby Broom, Makaya Craven, Dennis Carroll. So beautiful and so much fun. And you guys want to take a break? You want to chat a little bit? But
it's up to you. Yeah, it's up to you. We're good. We're here.
Okay. Well, let's chat just a little bit, and then I will let you go. Anybody have any questions from the audience? I have a couple. All right, let me go. Actually, I'm going to make a statement and then see if I can turn that into a question. One of the things I really love doing is going to museums, seeing artwork. One of the reasons I like that, because I know nothing about art. And so when I go there, it just sort of washes over me, and I don't have any idea how they do it. It sort of doesn't matter to me that I don't know how to do it. It's all just kind of magic. And when I see abstract art, I see things that sometimes are made of things that are recognizable, but they're fragmented and they're put together in a different way, and I see them in a totally new way. And that's kind of how I feel when I listen to this music. When you do Sweet Georgia Brown or I Got Rhythm, and songs that are part of our collective DNA because we grew up, you know, in America, but you then fragment it and put it together in a whole completely unusual way. It makes me hear these songs completely differently. And I'm wondering, I'm not quite sure how to turn that into a question, except that I think it gets to somehow the nature of improvisation or getting into how you think about how you take these things apart and put them back together. Because it is really unique. Do you have a thought about that?
No.
Thank you. That's our show. Have a great night.
We try not to. Oh, here. Okay.
Yeah. Here, I'll
give it. I got it. We really try not to think about it at all, really. The way that we play is just something that really has evolved quite organically over time. We are all enamored with jazz music. We grew up on, well, you know, I won't even say we grew up on it because I know I didn't grow up on jazz. Dennis probably did more than, because your dad kind of raised you a little bit on it. I mean, but when did you get into it? When you were in your teens, right?
Yeah.
Or before?
It was always around the house.
So it was always around
the
house.
I was always hearing the music.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, okay, so, you know, we're all not jazz babies. I mean, you know, well, Makaya's dad is a musician as well, so maybe I'm the only one. I'm the oddball. There was music around the house, but, you know, a variety of music, and I listened to the pop radio, which was really, you know, what drew me to music in general. At some point as a teenager, I got into jazz, but I think what my take on what I'm doing is trying to approach approach jazz really in a personal way. You know, that's really all it is. I mean, it's only, if it's special, it's only because my DNA is different, and I just follow my muse, and I don't, feel that I have to adhere to any rules. I mean, the rules are there. They're part of the music. There is structure to the music. There's form to the music, but that's where it ends. Your ability to interpret is free, and that's the meaning of jazz. Being able to find a personal way to interpret, through the medium of whatever it is, through the song, and through the genre of jazz, which has a history and a lineage. It's over 100 years old that we definitely reference at every turn, but there are also a variety of other things that enter into the picture stylistically, and so there it is.
Great. Yeah, I mean, tell me if you agree with this. I've always felt that like classical music is sort of a celebration of an ideal. You know, it's when it's, they're sort of trying to approach, perfection is the wrong word, but something they're trying to approach what the composer intended or something like that. Where I've always thought, so that's classical music. Jazz music seems to be the celebration of the individual.
Well, I think that's what classical music became. Mm. Right, because I don't know if it was so much that when it was being practiced.
Well, that's a good point.
In the 17th and 18th centuries, right? I think
right.
They were probably more like us.
Yeah, yeah.
And they just didn't have recordings to celebrate to retain the works of these
right, to listen
musicians.
To over and over and over. Yeah.
So it became a music based on composition because that was what could be kept.
Right,
So it is what it is. So now jazz is what it is, and fortunately, due to recordings, we can preserve the work, which and yes, it is a celebration of individuality and the individual's ability to express.
And that's a great point. I mean, in earlier centuries, you could keep a composition, but you couldn't keep a performance. And now you can keep a performance, and that's how so many of us learned. What we've learned, either as musicians or just as listeners, through one performance that we heard over and over and over and over and over, which was never possible before.
And that's in all styles after the advent of the the phonograph record, right?
Yeah, exactly. I will ask again. Anyone have any questions? Yes.
I'm reaching for. I think you said it all, right?
Yeah, right.
You basically that was the statement that couldn't be turned into a question.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
That's okay though. But no, we appreciate.
Yeah.
We appreciate you as hopefully as much as you do us, and that's what makes this thing work. You know, when we make our recordings, and that's basically really, really it. When that's the big offering we make is the recording. You know, and so when we do that, we're offering that to the world, and we have no idea if it will have any impact at all. You know, it's not a given, it's not assumed, but, we have our fingers crossed. And so when we can come here, and early on I'm going, oh, there are only three people here.
Yeah, right. Right.
As I'm doing what I'm supposed to do.
I was one of them.
Yeah, right. And we're, five.
Four. Well, Carl.
But anyway, okay. But, so we don't know what's going to happen, and we appreciate it I'm still kind of surprised, which is may sound silly, but it's the truth.
Yeah, yeah.
We met on the scene, as it were. you know, the jazz scene is, it's a community. And it's, you know, it's regional, and then it's national, and then it's international. You know, everybody's heard of Howard Levy, who happens to be
here
tonight.
Yeah, he's right here.
And we're honored that he's sitting here listening to us.
Exactly.
You know, and there are other great, great musicians here in the house tonight. Andy, Dave, Kelly, you know, there are a bunch of them here. So hopefully we support one another, we hear about one another, we pay attention to what's going on in our local communities and outside. So I had heard about Dennis, and I'm sure, you know, he maybe heard about me, and we just kind of ran into each other, and we wound up on a gig together, and which is a fancy way of saying a performance. We wound up on doing some jobs together, and that's how it started. I felt something, I felt a kinship in the way that he played, that, you know, we can pick up pretty automatically as musicians, just like, you know, it's like people and personalities. You don't click with everyone. It's the same thing in music, you know.
Yeah. Well, we're going to let these guys have a break because I...
Dave had a question. I know it was
going to
be good.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry.
Dave Miller, great guitarist.
Do not want to stop that. Go.
I just wanted to ask you, I know you are a huge fan of Wes Montgomery, and I was wondering what your favorite
Wes Montgomery. Ooh, that's hard. That's really hard because half of the reason why it's hard is because I can't remember the names of them. No. Let's see. You know what? I really like Guitar on the Go. I like those trio records, those first Wes Montgomery trio records before he was famous, when he played with his local cohorts, Melvin Ryan, the great, 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 underrated, great organist. Had a personal sound, played that instrument like no one else, and with the utmost taste and class and great everything, you know, harmonic understanding and technique. So Melvin Ryan and Wes and I don't remember the drummer's name, I'm sorry, but those were some great records, and they were just, you know, playing around Indianapolis. And fortunately, Orrin Keepnews got a wind of them through Cannonball Adderley, and the rest is history. So Orrin Keepnews was a great producer who just passed a couple of weeks ago. So yeah, that's the one where he does The Way You Look Tonight and Dearly Beloved, right? Woo! I mean, you know, come on, for like unabashed jazz, that's the greatest. He was one of the best improvisers in jazz music, period. Forget the guitar, to me. And then I love the records that Day in the Life and... what's the blue one with the mist? I can't remember the name of it. The Verve, and I don't know if they were CTI yet, but maybe the Verve and the CTI records. I love the pop things that, you know, he does Say a Little Prayer and the pop songs of the 60s, and he got flack from staunch diehard jazz music, you know, jazz purists. Rather, that he sold out, and yeah, man, he played great. To be able to deliver a melody the way that he did and take eight bars of a solo and have it just be, I felt all those solos were dripping with just as much emotion and everything everything else that was happening in jazz at that time in the 60s. I was like, man, I hear the intensity of John Coltrane in this solo right here, and he's playing it on a pop song. So, yay, Wes.
All right. Well, thanks so much for coming. Thanks for sticking around. There's a whole nother set coming, so I want to make sure these guys do get a break. And let me... Well, I'll let you take a break, and then I'm going to come back and tell you a little bit about what's coming up next week and the weeks following, right before they come back. But thanks so much, folks. Oh, and I'm sure Bobby's got CDs here.
Yes,
so please
I sure
come and
do.
See it. Come and see Bobby if you want some CDs. And also, we did have a really nice review in the Trib last week, and I have a little happen to bring a small copy of that to show everybody. Folks, while the guys are making their way back to the stage, I'll just really quickly tell you who's coming next week. Next week is going to be Art Davis, Jim Cox, and Dennis Luxon. Art Davis is a fantastic trumpet player, kind of in the mold of Chet Baker, sort of, and also plays the earlier stuff like Bobby Hackett. I mean, really, really a wonderful player. And Jim Cox, a wonderful bass player, and Dennis Luxon, a great piano player who actually played with Chet Baker. So if you're into a small group like that, you will enjoy that next week. Again, thanks so much for coming. Thanks so much for sticking around, supporting live music. And I turn it now back over to Bobby.
Walking the line and not wanting to keep it, legible, I guess. But I hear you.
Thank you.
I had to laugh the other day. You know, my son is four, And he, yeah, no, I had to laugh at that too a lot of times. Like, what? but yeah, he's four. And so there's a new Little Rascals movie, brand new. And they, yeah, tell me about it. And they use the theme song, the original theme song. So yeah, you know, my wife says, you know who plays that song, Cole? You know, and it's funny because I feel so old when I play that song, because my mom, when I used to watch that, my mom told me, yeah, we used to go to the theater and, you know, they would have the shorts before the film, and that was the shorts, was the, you know, our gang. And I'm like, okay, when you were a kid going to the movies, ooh, that's ancient. So it's some old stuff, but I'm glad they revived it. So now I feel like kind of current.
All right, one more and we'll call it a night. Yeah. Thank you.
Dennis Carroll, Makaya McCraven,
and Bobby Broom.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. No, you. It's my wandering eye, but I'm looking at you, Bob. Thank you. Thanks a lot, guys. We appreciate you. Hope to see you next time before too long, right? Okay. See you then. See you around the hood.
Thanks so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for coming out. Thanks for supporting live music at Evanston. It really does mean the world to us. And thanks especially to Bobby, Makaya, and Dennis here for a fantastic, fantastic ride. What a great evening this was. Yeah. Please remember to take those table cards with you if you like. Look us up on, we've got a website that's kind of cool. You can sign up for our newsletter if you like. Next week, Art Davis, Jim Cox, and Dennis Lux, and another really, really great trio. And then after that, we're going to sing into spring with several vocalists, which are really great. So keep up with us, and please come back. Thanks so much for coming, folks.